Hey, this is Doug Field, along with my co-host Brent Macy, and welcome back to this segment of Health Consumerism Radio. We're going to get into a very popular discussion right now around exchanges, and specifically around the individual exchange options and the connectivity with employer-sponsored healthcare. And joining us to lead that discussion is Scott Osler, VP of Business Development with GetInsured. Hey, Scott, good morning.
Hey, good morning, guys. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, thanks for joining us bright and early out west there in California. How's California this morning?
Well, if I were there, I'm sure it would be but I'm actually in Kansas City right now.
Oh, you're right. Okay, great. Yeah. Not a bad place to be either. Well, hey, great to have you here. Give our audience a little backgrounder on GetInsured, and then we'll get into some of the other discussion points.
Sure. Yeah, the simplest way to think about GetInsured is that we're an online consumer marketplace representing about 200 different insurance companies and about, somewhere between 7,000 and 8,000 plans. And it's a place where consumers nationwide come in and buy, shop for and purchase individual health insurance. Mm-hmm. And we're also a technology platform that powers the functioning state-based marketplaces that are out there. So we've got about three or four contracts in place now, going after a few more. And one of those includes Covered California, which is the largest.
Okay.
State-based marketplace.
I didn't realize you guys did that. That's great.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah. And then on the, on the private side, we're also a web-based entity. And for those that are sort of unfamiliar with what that means, on our GetInsured.com marketplace, we've got technology integration with healthcare.gov and an ability to help, consumers or employees of, maybe part-time populations, for instance, enroll into subsidized coverage into these public marketplaces.
So you can, the term's been used, shovel. You can shovel individuals to the right place. If it's an employee population, you can move them to the right place.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, I think I'd prefer to use something a little bit more glamorous than shovel.
Yeah, I do too. I've heard that used too many times, but I agree with you, actually. So.
But yeah, we're based in Silicon Valley. We've got call centers in Phoenix and one in Atlanta, which I believe is where you guys are today.
Yeah, we are, exactly, Scott.
And Scott, when you look, employers have this healthcare law that they have to deal with, and, what does it really mean for their business? What do you kind of see, employers doing in the space relative to the mandate?
Yeah, so it's a good question. I think, last year we didn't fully expect to be immersed in the employer space at all.
Mm-hmm.
But we saw some disruption there. We saw employers thinking about how to enable individual health insurance as part of their benefits mix. So we know that there's a mandate for employers to offer, insurance to their full-time equivalent employees or face penalties.
Mm-hmm.
And we started seeing the earliest shift, I think, in, the types of employers that, typically in restaurant, hospitality, retail.
Mm-hmm.
We saw a lot of shift last year with those employers who had historically offered maybe limited indemnity products or discount plans to part-time employee populations. And, the concern I think we saw is that the employee sometimes thinks that that's real insurance,
mm-hmm.
that, maybe it satisfies the individual mandate. And employers were concerned that, if they keep those plans, those employees might, get hit with a tax penalty at the end of the year, and there might be some liability. So we saw a lot of employers thinking about how do we take certain employee populations and move them to the individual market.
Mm-hmm.
And the categories that I think were the quickest to move were part-time, ineligible spouse and dependents, COBRA-eligible employee mm-hmm. populations, and then for us on the retiree side, those that are kind of pre-Medicare or pre-age 65.
Mm-hmm. Now, you can actually work in conjunction with a group exchange model working with a large employer group, right?
Yeah, absolutely. So we're, our solution is it's integrated into some private exchange technology platforms that exist out there.
Mm-hmm.
So we've got a relationship with B-Swift. We've got one with Benefit Focus. And then we also have an active partnership strategy with brokers that exist out there that include, Mercer, Buck Consultants, Lockton, and others. So we sort of view ourselves as a platform that can plug in to service those employee population segments that might not otherwise be serviced by, historically by those kind of larger brokers who have more of an emphasis on maybe Medicare retirees, the active population, and the consulting side.
Scott, we talk a lot about this fall's open enrollment period being a real critically important one, that some of the outcomes that potentially can come out of this will drastically accelerate the adoption of, defined contribution and exchange models. What do you guys see?
I think time will tell. I think what we've seen on the employer side is a lot of curiosity and a lot of interest. We're seeing some that are, kind of those early adopters that are starting to move. But I think it's early. I think what we're seeing is the majority of the opportunities we see on the employer side are integrating or enabling GetInsured as a solution for those employee populations on a standalone basis. And maybe thinking about, if they want to move to a private exchange in the future, can it be better integrated at some point, down the stream? So I think it's moving in that direction. We're not seeing movement in masses, over the past, last year or this year. But I certainly, agree with, that it's going to be moving in that direction.
I think the market could be surprised. I mean, there's going to be bumps in this road. Let's face it. I mean, it's a long road that we're getting on. I think it's going to move quicker probably than the people anticipate if the outcomes are, coming out of some unique workforces. I mean, everyone kind of understands, as you pointed out, kind of restaurants and retail real estate and some of these organizations, utilizing exchanges, both group and individual. I think we see some traditional workforces, pure white collar manufacturing start coming out. I think it may accelerate this movement. Do you kind of see some of the same?
Yeah, I do. I think those that move, quickly in the first couple years, everyone else is watching. So it's going to be kind of this domino effect, right? So, and I think people will look at the, employers, even that aren't in those categories that we just talked about, are going to be looking at, whatever is analogous with their employee populations. And I think, it doesn't have to be, the emphasis doesn't always have to be on part-time, blue-collar, those types of things.
Right.
We're seeing a lot of activity even with large employers that don't really have large part-time employee workforces, and they're trying to find ways to, replace COBRA with something that, reduces costs for the employer and something that's far more affordable for employees, and something that's really easy to implement, right? So it's really just about communicating a different solution and making, access to private insurance or individual plans available to the employee as an alternative to what they would, historically evaluate as a COBRA.
Scott, any specific, employee size group that you guys are working with, or does it vary? Does it vary quite a bit?
No, I mean, it ranges, right? So we have, some employers that are, under 100 that are thinking about just completely abandoning benefits and employer-sponsored insurance, and they use our platform to enroll those. And then we've got, employee populations that are part-time that have, 100,000 or more. And then I think and then there's this layer that's COBRA, right? And we've got those types of populations that have, churn every month that are, in the 200 to 400 terminated employee range that are always kind of this year-round qualifying life event audience that can enroll into coverage on public exchanges at any time. I think what we're seeing there is, the average COBRA premium, even if you're like 28 or 29 and healthy, is about $500 a month if you're trying to, purchase something on COBRA. And on average, on the public exchanges, that those same, similar types of plans are going to be around $82 a month on average. Value proposition to an employee, and really the theme with all of this, whether it's an employer that's trying to replace COBRA or trying to do something different with their part-time employee populations, it's really hard for an employer to curate something better than what exists now under the Affordable Care Act in the private market or with individual plans. It's going to be more affordable and for qualified health plans, and it's really about plugging in a service that connects employees to those options versus trying to do something the employer is sponsoring and adding cost and overhead and burden.
Scott, when you look at communication and education, is that a big focus for you guys as well?
It's huge. Yeah, I mean, I think in general, still this year, there's a lack of awareness around the basics of the Affordable Care Act.
Right.
So we talk to, you know, part-time employees, if we talk to any employees, they are still unaware that there's an open enrollment period, for instance.
Mm-hmm.
They're not aware that there's a penalty or that there's a mandate to buy.
Mm-hmm.
The availability of tax credits and cost-sharing reductions and all these things that make it financially more affordable, they're not aware of those. So, yeah, the communication, you know, a lot of oftentimes it starts through the employer. We have a communications program and, you know, assets that we enable and provide to employers where they can kind of plug it into their existing communication channels.
Mm-hmm.
But really it's entirely about, you know, awareness, education, and then, you know, providing them an online place where they can go and shop, or, you know, providing the 800 number so that they can get, you know, support from a licensed broker and a call center that can provide the same education and help them through the shopping and enrollment process.
And really helping them to choose the right plan that, that really fits their family structure, kind of getting it really defined to that individual. What would purely just be the individual, or would it be helping them, you know, cover their families as well?
It's for both. I mean, you know, I think what you tend to find is it's very personal. It's, you know, an employee that's calling in often has a spouse and dependents that they need to enroll. This is something that's, I think that's something that, you know, we work with employers to understand. It's no longer, you know, the reality is that it can, you know, the employee can refer neighbors and, you know, family and friends to the same 800 number.
Mm-hmm.
So it's all about, for the employee, let's understand. And our platform and our approach to customer service is one that we really want to understand, you know, if you're eligible for tax credits or Medicare or Medicaid, you know, up front to help you understand your eligibility. And then from there, it's, you know, determining how you're going to use the plan, how many office visits, prescriptions, do you have a doctor that's important to you? And then feeding that into an experience that will help you determine which plan is going to be right for you, and not necessarily the cheapest plan, but the one that's going to protect your out-of-pocket spending best throughout the entire year. And I think also, you know, there's a lot of skepticism that we have to overcome based on the rollout of the exchanges last year.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and so a lot of what we have to do is, you know, provide that education and just, and using licensed brokers in contrast to what you typically find at these state marketplaces or the federal marketplace where, you know, they don't have licensed brokers in the contact centers. They're kind of point-and-click help versus getting into the nitty-gritty about how the plan is going to work for the employee.
Well, Scott, we really appreciate you joining us on the program today. Let our audience know how they can find you.
Sure. You can go to GetInsured.com and find all the information you need there.
All right, Scott. Hey, really appreciate it. Have a great weekend. And if you can join us out at IHC Forum West, we'd love to have you come. That's November 10th through 12th. And, again, thank you so much for joining us.
All right, great. Thanks for having me, guys.